Okay, hello everyone. Let us start our lecture, our class. I hope you hear me all. Do you hear me? You can write in chat and please you mute yourself if not yet. Saying yeah, you hear me. Great. So I apologize again for belated notification about the Zoom lecture, but we did not expect the snow this morning. And when I woke up, I start getting emails from students. Students ask me if we have lecture or not. And well, then following provost request, and it was suggested that if you have bad weather, like you're in all troubles we have, you switch to Zoom meeting. So I made a decision to have Zoom lecture to be on safe side. And key point here to make sure, because when there is snow, even you manage to come to the campus, it will be crowded. So in terms of pandemic, it's even worse. If you are really pack the bus, if you stay on the bus station, it's even worse. So I made a decision to switch to Zoom. And in fact, in the very early morning, I called to the provost office and they did not reply to me. But about 8:30, we got notification that all classes in the morning are canceled, actually, until 10:30. Well, I think we have 24 participants now. So I don't think we should cancel it. We should have our Zoom lecture, right? Especially I want to teach two parallel sessions so in the same day, so we don't cancel one of them. But again, let's have our lecture. If somebody does not join us, I record it and I will post it. But for future, so let's say like this. This, and we should be ready for everything. So this is in-person class. And I'm happy we eventually have in-person session after last semester, because I really, when I teach, I really want to see all of you. I want to see your faces. I want to see how do you react on my words, on my messages, such that I can stop and repeat. It's much better than what we have now. But we should be ready for everything. So I do recommend you every morning before our class, please check emails, check notification. I will try, of course, if you have to switch, I will try to update you as early as possible, but at least up to 8 o'clock, 8 a.m. in the morning, please watch. And I have a suggestion that in case of severe weather condition, in case of snowstorm, we better switch to Zoom than cancel it. Then we, unless we really have something very important, because there it's really we save time, we don't lose the lecture. That's one point. Second point. Again, we are still in time of pandemic, everything may happen. And many people say that after a couple of weeks, we still may switch to online. It will be mandatory to everyone. So we should be ready for this as well. Now, finally, I want to welcome you back to school. Maybe on Friday, we will have a lecture. I will see you in person. But please remember, in this semester, while I really encourage attendance, this time it cannot be mandatory. And please, you know, in university policies and you know everything. As soon as you feel some symptoms of COVID or flu or whatever, if you don't feel well, you better, if you think, should I go to the university or should I stay home? Believe me, you better stay home. This time you better stay home, right? And I tell you again, like I told for third semester in the series now, your key task now, our task now, is to survive and stay healthy. And as far as I know, all my students whom I taught so far are still alive, luckily, and most of them are healthy. So key point, really, you should stay healthy. You should follow all the regulations. And as long as we don't have vaccine and good medicines, key point is your immune system. So I'm not a doctor to tell you what you should do, but you should sleep well. You should eat well, you should eat vitamins, proteins. In that case, if you get sick, you will really survive. That's only we can do now. And please remember, if you feel bad, when you come to the university, it's not only your health, but health of your neighbors, your friend, your fellow students. And remember that we don't know health conditions of other people. You may influence your instructor and your instructor can influence his or her family members or department chair, somebody elderly or pregnant women or somebody with conditions like diabetes, cancer or whatever. And eventually we may kill some. We don't want this. So if you have doubts to come or not to come, stay at home and no problem this time. No sanctions, it's really encouraged. Now, right after our class, assume that our class is in person in the room G883. Right after this class, I will give online lectures on the same class. It's another session of MAE320. So please, I will send you Zoom link. It's already actually posted. I sent you last night. So if you cannot come in person on my class in regular time, go to that Zoom link and attend it. And I know it's not the same, but I try to teach online in the very similar manner that what we teach in person. Maybe less writing on the blackboard, but slides are the same, homeworks are the same. It's very similar session. So please do it. If you cannot do it, for instance, well, you have other class. Anyway, those Zoom lectures will be posted on YouTube, on eCampus, so you can rewatch them anytime. And in fact, all my previous year lectures are already posted. And you can Google them. I will send you links. You can watch them as well. And thermodynamics does not change much. So you have plenty of options. So if you if something goes wrong, if you feel not comfortable, don't come to the lecture, no problems. Okay, so at this point, I think let me share screen and we will start start dealing with this class. So, and accounting for what we have now, accounting for the problems, really you should be very familiar with eCampus. I hope you are familiar with eCampus. But that's our major point of communications, email and eCampus. So I think you know how to use it. I will just, if you see my screen, yeah, here is a notification that classes are canceled, it just appeared. So if you go to eCampus, you will see many things here. Basically, you may have this or similar interface, right? So basically here are our classes, you may see. Your classes, well, you're taking, and here is classes as I'm teaching. So here we are. So our class is 2021-01-02. This is our sessions. And it's very, if you forget the way it is, it's very easy to realize because 2021 is the year, 01 means January, MAE320, and this is your second session here, right? So please, you go to this class. Somebody asked, somebody came later. So no, you did not miss anything serious. Plus I just gave some introductions and I told that I wish you to be healthy. And I told you that when you're not able to come to the lecture, go through Zoom and it's okay. And also I will post recording of this lecture anyway, so you can rewatch it later. So here is the interface of this class and you, everything you watch, what you need, it will be here. Here you will see your course content. So you will go here. Here you will see lecture slides they already posted, homeworks, exam, quizzes. Here I will post lecture videos from concomitant sections. Everything will be here. So if you go, for instance, to your homeworks, well, that's what you will see. And basically here will be homeworks. Now they're empty, they're not posted yet, but they will be soon. So that what you will do, you will go here, you will open it, you will take a look. You will take a look in it and then submit it. And this time I do recommend, even if we have in-person class, I do recommend that you will do your homework and then scan and submit it through eCampus. It's easier for several reasons. One reason, you reduce the risk of contingency, like we talked so far, that we don't deal with papers, we don't exchange it. Second, it will always be on eCampus. So you and me and the TA will always see it. We can always discuss it. You can always claim and there is no chance that it gets lost. And eventually you can submit it any time before deadline. So you don't need to come to the lecture to turn it in and get it out and see it later. So that's the easiest way. Homework one, which is mandatory, it will be posted soon. I will prepare it. And basically it will be due February 1st. So you will have time to do it. But what I already posted and what I sent you last night, it's what I call optional homework, homework number zero. This homework will not be collected. It will not be collected. It will not be graded, but I do recommend you open it and do it by Monday, by next Monday. Please do it because it's important. Because what I'm checking here, what I'm testing here, it's math trivia. In this class, you have prerequisites, right? So you are expected to know mathematics. You are expected to know fractions, to know integration, especially integrals, and all these things. So please go through it. Please do it. And please make sure, I call it math trivia, please make sure this is really trivial for you, okay? If it's not trivial, let me know. We may have some extra help sessions to fix it. The worst scenario when in April, you come to me and say, please, I don't know how to integrate. And then it will be my choice. What should I do with you? Should I teach you thermodynamics? Should I teach you second law of thermodynamics or how to integrate? You don't have time then. So please do it now. If it's trivial, excellent. I'm happy for you. But if not, please do it. No, I don't post solution to homework number zero because it's trivia. Exactly. That's my point. If you need a solution for it, it means that something goes wrong. It means, well, let me be specific. Some solutions are here. When you talk about interpolation, you will see some kind of solution is here. So it will go. But something what you see here, something what you see here, it's really should be something trivial. If this is not trivial for you, it means that you need help. So please realize it. Okay, that's for optional homework. But for other homeworks, they will be mandatory and all solutions will be written well and posted. So that's basics what you should realize. That is eCampus, that's how you deal with, and all materials that will be on the eCampus. Lecture slides, homeworks, exams, well, exams, not solution of exams, but exam assignments, everything will be there. Now, everything was on the campus. Last night, there was something wrong with the campus. I managed to send you emails, but I did not manage to attach files unless throw the links. Well, I don't know what's wrong because I sent the same email to parallel session and it was okay. So I hope you will fix it, but I apologize in advance for all bugs we face. And again, in these circumstances, please, please excuse me and I excuse all shortcomings it may face from you. So please realize. Okay. So that's eCampus, that what you should know. Everybody knows the campus, no questions about eCampus. Then let's go back to lecture slides. So basically here, lecture slides are posted and we can start. And today we have like introductory lecture. And basically when we start introductory lecture, what I ask you, actually what is my, you know, what is my task for today? I want to inspire you to come again. We will meet 43 times. Today is first period of it, right? So I want you to come back on Friday. I want you to basically introduce what we are going to do in this class, hopefully in person. So today we discuss the content of the class, the materials and literature you have to help you, the procedure and grading. I do believe you are interested in this, don't you? And finally about instructor and TL. So here is me and I'm Slava Ackerman. And basically here you may see my biography. It's not very interesting maybe, but what is more interesting, my emails here, my like two business emails, you can send email to, and basically you can send email to each of them. And basically this is the best way to communicate with me. I will have office hours from you, just like I told you, after our class, it will be my online class. So unfortunately, I don't have much time out after our class. Just at 11, at 10 o'clock, I have another lecture online from my office. But then I have office hours from 11 to 12. So this year, we are recommended to do it by Zoom. And I posted Zoom link on website, so not in the office. But if you really want to meet me in person, we will meet. And my office is 273 ESB in Annex. It's just above the freshman engineering. And basically here is my office phone and here is my cell phone. And frankly speaking, in the pandemic time, I don't appear in the office very often. I used to work from home. Now I work from home because of snowstorm. But you can call me. And please, if you call to my office, leave a message, leave a voice message. I will get it and can reply. Also, here is my cell phone. I tell you, email is the best way to communicate with me and I try to reply. But please realize the following. you will see that I do reply emails. I try to reply everyone, but I also have my schedule and I have many students. So if the day, the night or morning before the exam date, I get 100 emails with urgent questions, I cannot afford them. So please understand. Okay, so please give me time to react. But otherwise I will reply and you will see. So it's me. Now, we will have also TA or grader. I don't know exactly. So yesterday they told me it will be Ben Robinson. Maybe yes, maybe not. He should reply on this. And actually, in fact, I asked him to come to the class today to introduce himself to you, but you may understand he is not here with me at home now. Maybe we'll see him next time. But he will also have office hours. He will have email. So he will react on you. So you will have time. So me and him, we will help you as much as we can. And if you cannot come to office hours, if you are busy, we will find extra time. Also, the TA will give you help session. I will talk later a little bit before homework due date. You will have help session when we will be there. And please respect your TA, whether it's bad or not, because this is a person who will grade you. So please realize, I am not actually grading you. I am teaching you. You will evaluate me through student evaluation, but he will grade you. Respect him. And that's good. This is good because, you should not worry to talk to me and demonstrate what you know, what you don't know. And frankly speaking, well, if you don't like your TA, you can claim to me and you can ask that I will grade your particular homework. But you know, statistically, historically, my grades are worse from any TA. So basically I'm more rigorous and catch mistakes. So you better go to TA. Now. What is more important? So especially it's in person class, so we can communicate. I will see your faces, I will see how you react. You know better than me what you know, what you don't know. So please, very often then when I ask students, do you understand? Nobody say not, because you don't want to show, you don't want to embarrass me. Please, if you don't know something, ask questions. Don't be embarrassed, don't be scared to look stupid. You better look stupid and be clever than vice versa, believe me. So if you don't understand something, come to me and I will try to. Second, I will try to be open and frank to you. So I think I'm quite polite person and I don't say bad words or whatever, but I will say you truth. If after talking to you, I will tell you that you know nothing, please don't be offended. It means that you know little and you should do something with it. If I tell you that you're in trouble, please believe me and follow what I ask you to do. If I tell you that you should do homework again, it's not a matter whether you did it yourself or not. It means that you don't know the materials. You should do it again to pass your exam. Okay? I am teaching this course 12th time now. It's my 12th and 13th session. So basically I know classical mistakes and I will do my best to help. Another point, this course is closely coordinated to we have three parallel sessions. One is taught by new instructor, Gabriel Hendrick. She was my TA in the past and I teach two parallel sessions, your session and one online session. All your three sessions will have the same homeworks. Well, exams will be different, but homeworks will be the same and help sessions will be the same. So basically we coordinate it. So that's the basic idea. When we know something from TA, we will know when he will be available, when he will help you. Regarding grading, so we have classical just gradings. So you should get 90 points to get A, 80 to get B, 70 to get C, 60 to get D, and so on. Well, again, please don't be worrying if for instance, you have like 89.5, I will upgrade you up to next level, but not much. And basically, regarding the grades, it's very seldom that we don't know where you are. So it's classical idea how to understand what your grade is. So what is A? A typically means that you are really good. You can solve any problem. Maybe sometimes you do minor mistakes, but not very often. But still, that's why you don't need 100. It's enough to get 90. What is B? B means that you are still very good. You can solve any problem, but you regularly do some mistakes. Maybe you are not accurate. Maybe you did not learn much when you did not practice. So most likely you will get B because you do some mistakes. What is C? C means that, there is some gap in your understanding. You don't know something. There is something, some type of problems that you cannot solve. Maybe everything else is okay, but something is missed and you're at sea level. And DF, so on, it means that you get lost. You stuck, you don't know what to do. So believe me, so I am pretty sure that all of you can get A or B for this class. There is no something that you cannot get, but it's difficult. But remember, you can, and unfortunately, not all of you will get A or B. And I know some of you took my class before, so it, which means that you are at second, you're trying again, so you didn't get A or B last time. But I had very difficult cases in the past, and I remember when students managed to pick up and catch up. Just follow, just try the best you can, just deposit enough time for this course. It's not easy. And read my emails that I sent to you, follow all instructions, and you will be okay. You can get A or B. So what you see here? 10th homework assignments. So you will have 3 midterm exams. We do 3 exams because you want to see at each level how we are. So we don't wait until April to see that something goes wrong. Each exam will be 20 points of your score, 20%. Final exam will be 30%, and 10% goes through homeworks. You may ask, why only 10% through homeworks? It's too small. Yes, and it's intentional. Because if homeworks will cost more, it will actually tempt you to copy, to cheat, or at least to copy from your friends. Because if homeworks means a lot, you will have chance. Okay, I can do it myself, or somebody will help me and I will get better grade. So we are not going to catch you. We stimulate you to do it yourself. Well, collective work is okay, but brute copying is not something that we want. And please realize, homeworks cost only 10 points. If you copy your homeworks from somebody, but fail at your exams, nothing will help you, right? So you better fail at your homework, but do it yourself. You better fail with it. You better struggle with it. You better have difficult time with your homework. But then you will get my authorial solution, compare with your solution. And then you will see what's wrong. You will do it again, and you will know what to do. And then you will come to the exam and get good score. It's much better than vice versa, believe me. That's why. What other things you can get? Also, you'll have attendance activity. So like I tell you, for simple attendance, this year I will not do any points for you because again, I don't want you to get sick and come sick just for attendance. But for activity you will get, if you are active, either in Zoom now or in person, I will give you some kind of bonus points, bonus tickets. Well, this time the bonus tickets will be virtual, but they give you extra 0.5 points to your final score. And sometimes it helps. So many people are active and it helps them. Plus, you will have optional quizzes. They will not cost many points, but they will give something. And basically now I can tell you, people ask, do you curve or not? No, I don't curve. And whatever you will get, you will get. Why we don't curve? I will tell you. Because every year I have some excellent students who end up with cumulative more than 100, 105, sometimes 110. If I curve, what will happen? 110 will drop to 100 and your 90 point will drop to B level. You don't want this, right? Try to get bonus tickets, try to get bonuses through quizzes. And also what I used to do, sometimes I do typos, sometimes I do intentional mistakes. If you catch my mistake and report to me first, who will do it will get bonus. Now, again, these bonuses don't help much. If you get F at your final exam or one of the exams, it will not help you much. But if you're in the borderline, it does help so you can go up. It helps. So here is, this is not from previous year, one of previous years. You will see that my score, how my scores that people get in my sessions and from other instructions, so instructors. So you will see that I am quite okay. And basically, people from my session can get A or B easily. More than half will be A's and B's. Not all of them, but it's possible to get. And the best strategy here, do your homeworks and do it yourself. And basically, what you will see here, here is a classical diagram from previous level classes, and I will draw something for you as well. So what you see here, well, each of students correspond to one marker in this diagram. So this axis is exams, average exam score, and here you see average homework score, okay? Exam versus homework. And you, what you can see here is that most of students are along this diagonal. So your homework score does correlate with your exam score. So even your homeworks don't cost much, you will see that do your homeworks, do it yourself, and you will be okay. Well, it's not for everyone. Some people manage to write exam well without homeworks. Well, try if you want. It's not easy, but try. Take a risk. And some people, well, still fail at the exam with good homeworks. Well, maybe they are cheating at homeworks. Maybe that sometimes it happens, well. But most likely you will be okay if you do your homeworks. I believe, you believe me in this diagram, and I will show you own diagram in February. So what do you have in the session? What materials, what we're talking about? What do you have here? Please see. So basically, there are a lot of things that will help you. One thing is your textbook. This is a textbook on thermodynamics. Well, officially we have this latest edition, thermodynamics. It's edition 8 by Sergel and Boyles. I don't insist you to buy latest edition. I know it's expensive. It's okay if you have any of previous editions. It's okay if you have electronic copy. Believe me, thermodynamics does not change much since previous years. The only point, what you should remember, I will give you homeworks. Homeworks are not from your textbook. Why is your homeworks not from your textbook? Because all solutions already exist and all students can get it. So we don't want this. But sometimes, and very actually often, in your homeworks, I will give you extra supplementary optional problem from the textbook. These are from this latest edition. So if you use old textbook, numbers may be different. So you can check with your friends and check. But that's the only thing. Otherwise, any textbook is okay. But please, please have your textbook. It's important. I should tell you a couple of years ago, when I get comments on student evaluations, they're actually good. But one student wrote, you know, lectures were good, but they were not enough, so I had to read my textbook sometime. So believe me, I am not replacing your textbook. 50 minutes that we have in the class, it's not for that. I am helping you to get through examples, through basic ideas. You should read your textbook. I am not replacing it. I am not comparable to the authors of this book. Believe me, they are much better than me. You have to read your textbook. Don't depend on your lectures. Now other people say me, okay, if I am very good, may I just follow your lectures, attend lectures, and don't read the textbook? What I should tell you, try, take a risk. But I don't believe it's okay. You know, I am not reading your textbook anymore. I assume I know. If you believe that I can transfer all my knowledge to you right away without textbook, maybe, but textbooks are much better. So you should read the textbook. Also, you will have lecture slides. All slides are posted. And actually I will send it to you. When we come to your slides, I will send it to you by email, but they already posted on the campus. You can go through them. Now, they're helpful. What also helpful, lecture videos. As I told you, even our classes in person, in parallel, I will teach class online. Those lectures will be recorded and posted, and I will send you links. You are welcome to look at them. Moreover, last year lectures are already posted, and I can send you separate email with all these videos. You can follow them as well. The only difference in that last year lectures, there are different examples and different homeworks and different dates. Everything else is similar. So it's useful materials. Homeworks. You will have your homeworks, but what is more important, you will have them graded and you will have authorial my solutions posted together with them. So you can always compare and know how to do it. So your final task, go through the solution, my solution, and make sure that you now you know how to solve all these problems. So you don't, you know all mistakes you did and you never repeat them again. Okay, that's most important. That's why we do it. I should tell you, I prepare quite well detailed solution. I typically not write by type it, and typically it's very well described. So please go through this. Well, exams, yeah, also, yeah, as I told you, you have me and you will have TA. You have our service, our help session, our office. And what is important here, here is actually how it will be organized. So here is your course schedule and basically how it will be. So you will have about 8 homeworks, maybe. And basically they are straightforward. You have like, you go through your textbook, okay? So chapter 1 is homework 1, chapter 2 homework 2, chapter 3 is homework 3, and so on, so on. After each chapter, you will have homework. And here you see your schedule, it's in your syllabus. It's attached, and basically, well, I call it tentative, but we really try to follow it. Most likely, especially now, we don't need to cancel classes, we have Zoom. So basically, most likely it's fixed. So that will be your schedule, how we follow it. So your homework one, you typically each homework will be every week, every 2 weeks, every 10 days. And we will post it in advance, you should have enough time to do it. So homework one will be just to do February 8th, homework two due February 10th, and so on. Now, prior to homework, 2 business days prior to homework due date, we will have help sessions. It will be by Zoom this year from 5 to 7 p.m. So for instance, if your homework one is due Monday, February 1st, on Thursday and Friday week before, you will have help sessions. If your homework two, for instance, due Wednesday, your help session will be Monday and Tuesday, 2 days before. I do recommend you attend help sessions. At help session, instructor is helping you. And it's sometimes very helpful. Like if you, even if you think you know everything, it's okay to attend to double check. If you know nothing, you will see how other people solve the problem, it will be helpful. So please really, one way how to catch up if you get lost is help session. But please come prepared to help session. Neither instructor nor UTA will solve problems for you. When you come to my office hours, please read your textbook before and come. If you come to me and say, I have this question, I don't understand this, I will help you. But if you come to me and say, I don't know chapter 3, what can I do for you? I will not repeat my lecture again. I will send you to YouTube to watch it. I mean, where is my lecture is posted. So you will just waste your time, not my time. I'm at help session anyway or on office hours, but please come prepared. When you learn it, when you read the textbook and still don't understand something, I'm here to help you. So that it is. So, and you will see that, one more point. So I tell you, in fact, chapter 1 and chapter 2, these will be somehow a repetition of the of your prerequisite classes, like statics, dynamics, basic physics. So I expect you should be okay with this. So please, if you don't know these topics, it's bad. But if you are excellent in chapter 1 and chapter 2, if your homework 1 and homework 2 are trivial for you, it's great, but it still means nothing. Because real thermodynamics will start in chapter 3. At that time, please be prepared for something difficult, for some kind of cultural shock. And by that time, please print out property tables. I sent it to you last night. And also, actually, I do request you by the middle of February have hard copies of this, of this property table. It's really most important to have. It's really something that you need. So please have it. Please realize this. And that's why right after chapter 3, we have exam 1. It will be on Wednesday, February 24. Why, oh, I'm sorry, 26, February 26, Friday, February 26, I'm sorry. Why do we have it at that time? Very simple. This is, if you stuck at this point, if you fail your exam 1, it's very bad, of course, but you still have chance to recover and catch up. It's still end of February. You still have 2 months after this. That's why we do it. And that still will be enough for you time to catch up and get it. I know many people who fail at exam one, but still survive and end up with reasonable score. So that is how we proceed. That's basic idea. Any question at this point? Okay, there is one point that I want to discuss with you. Maybe when we have in-person class, we can work on it. So homeworks, as I told you, I suggest that you can do it in paper form, but I suggest that you scan and upload it on eCampus. If you bring it to my hand, it's still okay, but then somebody should do this work for you, so you better upload it there. How shall we do with the exams? I have a proposition. So we can do exam. The exams will be in our regular time from 9 to 9:50, a 50 minutes exam. It's quite short time. So what we can do? One way, we can do it in the class. But second thing, I propose that we do it online, like homework. So you will do it like I did last year. You don't need log browser, but you will do it on Zoom, such that I see your faces, you will turn on your cameras, and you will do this assignment, and then you scan and submit it. I will give you extra time to submit. Why? For some reasons, I tell you, why actually we did, why we have social distancing? Why do we have a distributed class now? You know, the worst scenario of pandemic is the following. Imagine exam time. Imagine many students do it timely, but really a lot of students wait until last minute. It's last 2-3 minutes when you think that you get some idea, you start writing. It always happens that at the end of the class, I am leaving the room and the crowd of students follow me to give it to me. Remember, this time I have another class right after your time at 10 o'clock, so I cannot wait. And imagine in the room, in our room ATC, it will be another students who are outside. So imagine the crowd. When I leave the room, a lot of students accompany me to give me this homework. We go through the door and another class came in. It can be super spread of COVID-19. And all our measures that we talk about will be useless in this crowd. That's why there is a proposition that we have only all three exams will be online. Of course, lectures will be in person. Hopefully, I hope, I still see the snow. I hope on Friday we will meet in person, but I hope. At least in March and April, there will be no snow. Now, but if you have quizzes, short quizzes in the lecture time, of course, again, they will be in person, but there is the idea that exams can be online. So think about this until Friday and we can vote how you want to have it, okay? Okay, any question about reglement, about anything like this? We still have time, we still have 15 minutes, so let me, not 15 minutes, about 10 minutes, but let's continue. Everything is understandable regarding reglement. Then let's discuss, so what is thermodynamics, right? So what are we going to learn in this class? And when I started, I typically ask, okay, guys, so what is our civilization is based on? What is big difference from us? What is the difference between us and say ancient Greeks or Romans? For some reason, I will talk a lot about ancient Greeks in this class, and this is conceptual. So you can write down. So what is the difference? What is the difference between our civilization and ancient Greeks, for instance? Because we have a lot of things in common. They had geometry, theater, they had science, they had literature, they had poetry, they had democracy, they had a lot of political games, they had a lot. It was very cultural community, but there is something conceptual difference. What is it? And basically, when we talk, what is the difference? Well, some people say high tech, IT, that's true, but it's not straightforward. Basically, I would say the word energy. Basically, it is energy, which is a backbone of our modern civilization, right? Energy. And it's not always the case, but most likely communities, countries, which consume more energy per capita, they generally speaking, they live better, they are richer, they have better properties, they have better health system and so on. Our civilization is based on energy. It was not always the case. Like I tell you, ancient Greeks, did not use energy much, and they were quite powerful. Sorry, but we are based on energy. And basically, now people consume about this amount of energy, 10 to the power 21 joule per year. Is it big amount? Well, looks like big, but how to compare to it? But we have many people also. I can say that it's not too big if you compare with solar radiation. From the sun, we get four orders of magnitude more. It's about 10 to the power 25 joule per year. What does it mean? It means that what we burn, what we use every year, we still have plenty of time to improve. But another point is that we consume more and more energy. General consumption is about 5% per year. And on this picture, you may see that how energy consumption grew from primitive time, from middle age, medieval time, from ancient time to now. And you may see that from, let's say, Roman times or whatever, consumption increases by two orders of magnitude. And this is per capita. Remember, in Roman time, all the population over the world was 200 million. Now we have almost 8 billion. So it's three orders of magnitude growth. And remember, now when we talk about clean energy, alternative energy, it's great. But we talk about energy efficiency, but we don't talk about reduction. We talk about to reduce emission, to reduce pollution, to stop burning something. But we never talk that we don't use energy. We still use more and more energy. And that makes sense difference from Greeks. Now, so how we use it? What do we have that ancient Greeks did not? We use energy for what? For transportation, for manufacturing, for industry, for heating, right? And basically, even now we talk about new sources of energy, still we hardly depend on combustion. Combustion, which converts heat into mechanical work. Up to now, 80% of energy we get comes from combustion. And what was the basics of industrial revolution in several centuries ago? It was when people managed to convert combustion. When many people invented actually Watt's machine, steam machine, or let's say internal combustion engine. When you can manage to burn something and convert chemical energy into mechanical, right? Heat into work. Why I say this? Because here you may see there are two things that we managed to do and ancient Greeks did not know how to do it. That's why their civilization was not based on energy. We know something that if Aristoteles was teaching this lecture, he would not help you. Well, I know something that he did not know, and you know now. It's thermodynamics. It's a Greek word, which means heat and power. So what do we know that they didn't know? Let me illustrate like this. Let's assume I start my lecture in a hurry, and I have a hot cup of coffee that I forgot to drink, and I forgot it here on the table. After my lecture, what will happen with this cup of coffee? Tell me, please. What will happen? I do believe that this cup will have room temperature. It will be cold, right? And room will be a little bit preheated, but very negligible, right? Everybody knows this? I believe so. Did ancient Greek know this? Yes, they knew this. May it be vice versa. You know, if I release this cup of coffee, that it will be vice versa. Most like ancient Greeks would tell you not, because system goes to what? To thermal equilibrium. So if I have like here, you may see I have hot block of iron and cold block of copper, when they come in touch, finally they lead to thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium means equal temperatures. So it's like this, right? So system, which is released, goes to equilibrium. It relaxes. Ancient Greeks knew this. But can it be vice versa? Can I preheat this coffee and keep in my room colder? Is it possible? And the answer is yes. Your fridge does it. What refrigerator does? Your refrigerator transfers heat from the environment to kitchen. That's how you keep these products, the food cold, right? So that's what one thing that we know, what ancient Greeks didn't know. You can transfer heat from cold to hot source against this one, against direction to thermal equilibrium. The same story about heat pump. How you can preheat your house? You transfer heat from the street to the house. That is refrigerator. Is it trivial? If it's trivial, let me ask like this. If it was in person class, it will be more suitable, but let me talk now as well. So imagine that I have here big box with ice that you typically use to cool soda, okay? And imagine I open this box with ice and release it in the room. What will happen eventually? What will happen with room temperature? What will happen with room temperature? Do you know?
It's going to decrease. It's going to be colder.
That's true. Excellent. It will be colder. Trivial, right? Eventually, ice will melt and temperature in the room will get colder. True. Now, what happens if instead of this ice, I have a fridge? Imagine I have a fridge in the kitchen and I open the door like you see on this window, on this picture. I open this window, open the door. What will happen with the temperature in the kitchen? Will it go up or down? Looks very simple or not?
Down.
Who thinks down and who thinks up? Let's vote. So people who, more people think down. And well, and don't be embarrassed because, don't be embarrassed because if you ask this question to Aristoteles or Plato or Socrates, they will reply the same. So you're in good team, but it's wrong. And that is conceptual difference between fridge and box of ice. Box of ice goes to thermal equilibrium and definitely it will cool the room. But what fridge does? Fridge works against heat transfer. When you, what fridge does? It transfers heat from your food to the kitchen. What happens when you open the door? You increase heat transfer between your kitchen and the food. Your food will be preheated by the kitchen. So your fridge will start work harder and consume more and more electricity and transfer more heat to your kitchen to sustain cold temperature inside, right? So your fridge will start bringing more heat into your kitchen and your kitchen will get the heat and it will consume more electricity. What is different between fridge and this box of ice? Because your fridge eats heat, it eats electricity. It eats electricity, it consumes electricity. It does not work for free, but that's what we have. Okay, that's one thing that we know what ancient Greeks did not. And another stuff, let's talk. Can we convert work into heat? For instance, what happened like this? What happened if I make friction by my hands? Now the weather is cold, if you're at the street, you better do it, right? And potentially you can burn something. And the same story, what happened if you do physical training? You get sweat or because what happened? Because you produce heat, right? Your mechanical work produces heat, you generate heat. So believe me, ancient Greeks knew this. They were very good in sports. They invented Olympic games and other games, right? They invented sport. So ancient Greeks knew that you can convert work into heat. But can you do vice versa? Can I heat my hands and they will be shaking? Ancient Greeks assume not, but we know it's possible. We know now that heat can produce work and all our power plants, like old trains with used steam machine, all our power plants, they're based on this. We managed to convert heat into work. Not directly because we should lose something. It's another story, it will be second law we talk about, but that's something that we know. Ancient Greeks did not know. They use hands, slaves, animals, camels, horses, elephants to produce mechanical action. We don't need this anymore. We use steam or more sophisticated devices, right? Steam machine can replace elephants and horses and slaves and hands. They do this. So these two items, heat into work, we can, and that's what we do. So basically what we are going to learn in this class, these are two items that makes us different from ancient Greeks. We know how to convert heat into work and we know, right? That's what we have. What makes us different from them? And why our civilization is based on energy while those are not? Because we know the following. We know how to convert heat into work, and we know how to transfer heat from colder to hotter body. Our fridge does. That makes a difference. And these two processes, two items, two cycles, constitute the basics of thermodynamics and the basics of all our modern civilization. That's how our cycles organize. We have power cycle, which converts heat into work, and we have refrigeration heat pump cycle, which transfer heat from bottom to the top. And that's why ancient Greeks did not manage to do manufacturing and consume energy. Well, we can do this. We do this. Okay, it's the 9:50. I will stop at this point. I will record this. Do you have any? And that's basics of this course. And I believe when we end up and I ask you about open door of the fridge, most of you will answer this. Okay, we had 28 people participating today. So basically most of people were here. I'm sorry if somebody missed the class, but I'm happy that we had it. I hope we will continue in person on Friday. I do hope. Otherwise, well, but please read emails until, like, let's say until 8 a.m. I can change the module of teaching, okay? Until 8 a.m., please check emails. And okay, please, I have a little time before the next lecture. I can, but I should not walk to my office. I sit at the same place so I can answer some questions if you have, please. Okay, any questions, please? For the Discord group. Okay, maybe at this point I can stop. Recording. I will post it anyway, right? And stop sharing screen. And basically stop record. Yeah. Any question, please?